What is going on, guys? This is JWAGS412, and what a goddamn travesty, man. It makes me fucking sick to my stomach. Why can they not get Resident Evil right? Why do they continue to abuse this franchise and disrespect the RE name? Why can they not make a decent live-action video adaptation of this video game? Who the fuck is directing this shit? There's so many problems with this, but let's fucking get into it.
I need rings, Super Bowl size. I need a fine dime with some Super Bowl thighs. You say you the truth, that's a Super Bowl lie. I flex on a nigga like a super swole guy. You come into the squad and you super gon' die. I make it look easy and I super don't try. It's funny, everybody always looking up to me, but I've always been a super short guy. Bye.
Always fucking terrible. Always. Ari, always fucking awful. So we start off in the new Raccoon City. Actually, no, we start off in the future, and then we go back to the past. Then the future, then the past. This whole season so far is future, past, future, past. You know, that stupid-ass Last of Us 2 shit that did not work. I hate that. Going back and forth. Almost like watching two different shows at one time, and they want you to go, oh, that's why that's happening, huh? It's predictable. It's lazy. I fucking hate the whole format in which they're shooting it. Now, this is not a review. This is not a, you know, this would be spoiler as fuck. It's not a review or my breakdown of saying, like, every little facet. No, this is my fucking rant about this video, about this fucking show. This is my rant about how fucking terrible RE shows and movies are in general. So this is an in-depth review. There's going to be spoilers. Warning, there is going to be spoilers. If you don't like that, click the fuck off the video now. But you start off in 2022 in the new Raccoon City for the flashbacks. And then in the future, or the, I guess present day, it's 2036, 14 years after the outbreak, where we follow our character. So the first thing we were introduced to is a post-apocalyptic world with terrible CGI, terrible-looking zombies. Then we flash back to present day 2022 to New Raccoon City. Everything's fucking white, everything's clean, and the name of the town is New Raccoon City, implying that there was an old Raccoon City off the jump. So, okay, so they blew up Raccoon City beforehand. Now they built a new Raccoon City. I guess Umbrella's still alive and well, and they fucking forgave them for fucking blowing up a whole goddamn town. But whatever. We are introduced to Billy Wesker, Jade Wesker, and Albert Wesker. Now, let's start off by saying Albert Wesker. I like the actor. That is a good actor. But he is not Albert Wesker. He does not play a good Albert Wesker. He is bald. He's fucking bald. Wesker is not bald. They could at least get this guy some blonde hair and maybe some black glasses. No, he's bald with big, huge glasses. Apparently, the story with him is he went through all this shit with Raccoon City or whatever, and he's now a loving, caring father who cares about the product, who cares about the lives of others, who is sentimental, and who... No, bro, no! That is not Wesker. Wesker is a ruthless killer who only cares about himself. He wants money, and he wants to watch the world fucking burn. Then we are introduced to Billy and Jade Wesker. These are Albert Wesker's daughters. They are apparently twins with different mothers, and they suggest it's fucking stupid. But, of course, as I thought, you know, Jade's the bitch, you know, she's the teenager who's going, like, oh, fuck you, dad, you always work too much, you don't spend enough time with us, you move across the country, you always, you know, just think about your work, like, it's just the typical, how many times have you seen that in a movie or show, fuck you, dad, you know, I hate you, dad, like, you all that, it's so goddamn cliche, and then Billy is, like, the daddy's girl who's like, oh, you know, dad's trying, or, you know, dad, it's fucking horrible, cringeworthy, I fucking can't stand it. So fast forward a little bit, and we are met with the whole high school experience, right? Billy's an outcast, they don't accept her, everything, she's weird, she gets bullied to the point where actually Albert Wesker, the head of Umbrella, has to go to a fucking parent-teacher conference. It's awful. But in the midst of all this, right, so Ellie is a vegan, of course. She loves animals, she hates animal abuse, she's like PETA, she's all against that. Well, she goes visit her dad at the lab at Umbrella's top security facility, and apparently Umbrella in 2022 just wheels around test subjects for everybody to see in an area where Umbrella's family members are just there and can lounge out. So Billy sees these rabbits, and she gets upset saying, oh, Umbrella's testing animals. She tells her sister Jade, I think Umbrella's testing animals. Oh, yeah? Let's go find out. So I kid you not, Billy and Jade, in the middle of the night, decide to steal her dad's ID and go to Umbrella to see what's really going on. And that's where, for me, a lot of it goes right the fuck downhill. So, Billy and Jade walk to Umbrella's top fucking research facility, right? In 2022. And they walk right through the goddamn front door. Are you fucking telling me? Do you expect me as a viewer to believe, as someone who's familiar with the lore of Resident Evil, especially in the year 2022 apparently, that they were able to walk through the front door with no fucking security, no armed guards, no fucking cameras, no motion sensors, no thermals, fucking nothing, walk right through the front door in the world's most fucking secure facility that's on the fucking ground level for some reason? They were able to walk through that bitch with not even so much as a fucking receptionist? Fuck you. That is plot convenience at its finest. We all know that Umbrella, they're working on this drug called Joy in this show, but no matter what they're working on, if they're testing live subjects, and so much so that they got a goddamn Cerberus dog on the main level here, like fucking 100 feet into the building, damn sure believe in our universe that's going to be way the fuck underground somewhere or in some obscure remote location, not in the new fucking Raccoon City fucking town where civilians live, like military barracks. It's not gonna be out there in plain fucking sight. Enough for a family member to walk right in there and in 2 minutes encounter and unleash a Cerberus dog. It does not fit with the lore. But anyway, so when they break in, you know what's gonna happen. You can already tell. You know they're gonna find something they shouldn't. T-virus related. They're gonna let it out, and probably it's gonna, you know, infect somebody. It's gonna get out. You know the whole story. That it was very predictable what was gonna happen, and that did happen. They went in there. They're looking around. Oh, what kind of shady shit's dad into? Look at these mice. Look at these rabbits. And they let out a Cerberus dog. Cerberus dog chases them. Billy ends up getting bitten. And then Jade kills the dog with a fucking fire extinguisher. And amidst all this, so now the alarms are going off because the glass is breaking. And still, nobody shows up. It's not until about 10 minutes later that Wesker finally fucking shows up. And he's like, oh, what happened here? Oh, and now he's in erase mode. Now he's got to erase the evidence. So he wipes all the fucking camera footage, right? Covers himself in blood and puts together this whole charade, like, you know, he let a dog out and he was working late hours and it's all his fault. Meanwhile, there is still not one person from Umbrella ever showing up ever. It's not until a half hour later when these alarms going off that fucking Umbrella fucking army actually shows up, and then we meet, what the fuck's her name? I think her name is Alicia. I forget her fucking name, but she is apparently the daughter of Dr. James Marcus, you know, one of the original founding members of Umbrella. You saw him in Resident Evil Zero. He was the leech guy. You know, he got killed off way back, you know, before even the mansion incident. But that's his daughter, and she's apparently now the head of Umbrella. And get this, of course, she is a lesbian. Check, check, and check. She shows up. She goes, oh, what happened here? He lies to her and says, oh, I think we got hacked, yada, yada. The whole thing makes no fucking sense. In the year 2022, that's probably my biggest complaint thus far with this show, is that these two teenagers were able to walk right in to the most secure lab Umbrella is supposed to have. You know, like the old games, how that shit would be, these labs would be in a mansion in the outskirts of Raccoon City, in a mansion nobody would ever come near to, in a fucking hive, an underground facility over a mile underground. But no, this shit's just on ground level for any fucking family member just to walk right in and, you know, and tamper with this shit. And some people will say, hey, well, they had their dad's credentials. Their dad's pretty high up in Umbrella. I don't give a fuck. There's no way that he doesn't have to go through somebody. There has to be fucking somebody in this facility. Maintain order. Watch the security footage. At least a goddamn receptionist. Fucking somebody. That is a huge plot hole. And then, after all this, right? So after he tells these girls, he's like, oh, you get out of here. I got this. They're able to walk right through the fucking back door. Right through the back door of this facility. And go the fuck home with no repercussions. Not being spotted on, like, you know, a traffic cam. You telling me that Umbrella doesn't have fucking cameras everywhere? Actually, the show does tell you that, because they got fucking drones everywhere. They're able to pinpoint any other incident or any intruder, any threat Umbrella is able to detect from a satellite system, but they can't tell who the fuck was in their main facility and have no security at their main facility. It is an awful plot line. It is an awful plot convenience, and it fucking took the immersion for me out immediately. Any form of believability was fucking gone. and everything I just talked about was in the first episode and the very, very beginning of the second episode. That's all the shit so far. And I got so much more shit to say about this. But please, let me know in the comment section if you guys want another video, another rant video, because it's going to happen this whole fucking season. This show keeps getting worse and worse and worse and worse, and I don't have time to put it all in one fucking video. So let me know in the comment section if you want another video. But so far, this show is fucking awful. This show is way worse than the movie Welcome to Raccoon City, and I goddamn hated that movie. So if you missed time, guys, join me, please like, comment, subscribe, all that bullshit. Talk to you guys next time. Thanks.